anniversary exhibition of the P.O.S.E.R.S. Life Drawing Club, I suppose we are, and I and my dear friend John Holder were involved in setting it up all that time ago. And P.O.S.E.R.S., I think originally we rather tongue-in-cheek called it the Painting and Observational Sketching an Expressionistic Rendering Society, and one of our old colleagues said actually it was the Pathetic Old Semi-Employed Rogues Society. Anyway, so, you know, we never took it too seriously. It was, a lot of us were illustrators and commercial artists, and it was just a chance for a few of us to get together and draw.
I did life drawing as a student. We used to draw all the time back in the 50s. We just spent hours, not a couple of hours, but all day and the next day doing life drawing. And it was absolutely amazing. And I've kind of done it since. And the point about drawing and life drawing is actually the underpinning of all visual art.
Some of the people that come to P.O.S.E.R.S. are there are sculptors, illustrators. Mm-hmm. Well, students come for free.
Yes, absolutely.
And there are painters, there are people who do no art in their day job, but yes, still love to draw. Yes. So it's
complete cross-section, isn't it?
Yeah.
And everything that life drawing can add to you as an artist. I was discussing how it's like being in a library when you do life drawing. It's a quiet time without any pressure to produce something, just a finished piece of work. And just enjoying being with other people who are similar and also enjoying the moment.
So I guess my wife works here at Anglia Ruskin University. She found out about this drawing group, and so I came out to join it. And I fell in love with it. You know, it's great to get out and just draw. You know, it's surprising as an illustrator how you don't get to draw enough, especially from just what's in front of you, what you're observing. So it's great to just get out and practice that. It's also a great way to get to know the other artists in town and, fellow illustrators like John Holder. You know, get to know the artist community here and hang out at the pub afterwards.
The other wonderful thing is that there are two artists who've lent their sketchbooks. John Harris has lent his sketchbook, and John Holder also has lent a wonderful variety of sketchbooks that he's been using over the years.
It's great, there's such a range. I really like how some of them are so soft, and then others are just like proper go for it in one go. You can really tell, you can tell a lot about personality in a drawing.
I think this is such a fantastic exhibition. It's a real testament to all the hard work that's gone on in this group over the years. My mum's been a really important part of the group. She's loved every minute of being part of it, and it's really nice to see. There's so much joy coming off the walls. It's just brilliant.
Well, it's the show that we put together for 30 years of P.O.S.E.R.S. It all came about because somebody I know who used to come to P.O.S.E.R.S. years ago said she used to come, and she came to the very first one, and she found the date on her sketchbook, and it was 1989. So I suppose it was kind of down to me, is that I said this to John, and then it all cooked up out of that. And John, your grandfather, he can't remember anything, so.
Jim, how did you?
He's very young.
How did you get involved?
Well, I came down here to teach, about 13 years ago, and immediately looked out to try to find out where there was some life drawing, and came along to the first session of P.O.S.E.R.S. that I called, and the rest, as they say, is mystery.
History?
No, mystery. Lost in the mists of time. And straight away, right from the very off, everyone knew I was there because I was drawing A1 with a stick and ink all over the floor in the very first moment I walked in, and haven't stopped since.
I studied here, so Chris Draper, my illustration tutor, sort of championed it. He's like, drawing is sort of like the backbone of any sort of discipline in art education, so I've just always been going to it every week, on and off, throughout the later years, and it's a really good group.
When you're doing something that interests you together with other people, it really does, it's a very bonding thing, I think.
Every Tuesday evening for a couple of hours, you can hear a pin drop. And then you sit and draw.
It is important that young artists are continuing the practice of life drawing, because it gives you, as we always say, the elbows. So it makes you have accuracy in what you're doing, and then you can make a decision later on if you want to abstract that, and what you might want to do with that. But observational drawing should be fundamental to every student's art student's life.
And the point about drawing and life drawing is actually the underpinning of all visual art. Whether you're a designer, a painter, a sculptor, a jewellery maker, any visual art, if you can draw, it's like the underpinning of, looking, concentration, seeing, trying to understand. If you can draw the human figure, you can draw anything.
I mean, Cambridge School of Art has always had a strong tradition in drawing, partly because the history of the school has always been quite unusually associated with illustration, graphic design, and printmaking, where drawing is very important. And of course, it goes back through students like Ronald Searle and Edward Borden, right back to the 1850s. I would say drawing is considered less important these days in fine arts, where the conceptual side, the philosophical side, is kind of taking precedence. But it's still very important for illustrators.
For the 2 hours of life drawing, it's just incredibly intense. You know, you're just completely focused and drawing, and then you can unwind, you can sort of release, go down to the pub and unwind a little bit. But it's a very intense experience drawing.
She's a good model. Standing here.
I won't sit there.
We had a new chimney.